Division I championship we go. Opening tip played the Sunrise. And then we'll bring it up here. Ron. Jumper, that's good from about 17 feet, and a 2-0 lead for Sunrise over Trinity International. Trinity will be in those black uniforms going right to left. Sunrise in the white uniforms going left to right here. And Daniels, it's off on the baseline. Nix for three, that's good. Triple for Daisha Nix.
On the right, he's on.
Yeah, that's one miss. There's a turnover as he gets the steal. Good pass on the inside. You can add an assist to that, too. There's a layup from Jackson Pillage. Five, two is the lead for Trinity. Chan. Left side guarded by Nix. Almost had it poked away. And back three. It off along the baseline to Otino. Puts it off in the corner. Three ball there is off the mark from Marco Moreau. Back to the way it comes. Bowery out front. Nix a long three. That rattles in and out. Rebound comes back down to Trinity. Three ball in the right wing. That's good. Triple for Dominique Daniels. And a timeout to Sunrise. Quickly, an 8-2 lead for Trinity. 6:20 to go in the first. Back in just a moment. Back to the MTS. Somehow made the shot. Back to the other side. Not out of bounds. Will remain with Trinity. Into the lineup comes Javier Gilchrist Blasco. On the baseline, three ball. That's good. Triple in the corner for Quentin Lowry. This is crazy. And this has been incredibly fast. 11-4. We got a whistle and a foul on the near side. And that will be on Javier Gilchrist Alexander. That's his first, team first. Milich had to swing it back out. Edwards with it.
It's amazing how much smoother the ball handling and everything is.
Alberry down the lane and lays it in. Boy, Dave has put together a good first quarter. 11-6 to lead the team. Daniels with it. Nice. In the corner. Down the lane. Floater. That rims off no good. Rebound pushed back up the other way. That's knocked away. Picking it up is Okino. Good pass into the front court. That's blocked underneath. And Nix will pick up his first foul. And team second at 4:14 to go in the first.
Walk them down that sideline and stop everything and yell out everything. They don't know how to play yet.
I think they're pretty good. Every now, you'll see him up, you know, every now and then. But a lot of times, yeah, hey guys, coach there. He gets up and talks when he needs to, doesn't he, Mr. Lockridge?
That's right. Only when he needs to.
Hits that. Second violation. Trying to get rid of the basketball.
Too much dribbling.
Marcelino Edwards will check in. Marcelino will check out. And that's what Coach Eric Adams is asking. Why aren't you getting rid of the basketball? So on it comes to Gilchrist Glasgow. Top to Nix. Down the lane, and he's fouling at the free throw line. It'll be on Paul Otino. That's his first, team second. Sunrise Christian out of Bel Air, Kansas. 15-8 on the year, coached by Eric Adams. Team International out of Las Vegas. 29-14, of course, coming into this tournament, coached by Greg Lockridge. Goes good by...
I kind of wonder what teams they lost to.
Well, yeah, they play the, you know,
they play the big boys.
You know, when you're talking about Hamilton Heights, that kind of stuff. So, I mean, not them specifically, but yeah, that kind of, that caliber. So 18-8 is the lead here for Trinity. Down the lane, blocked on the inside. Coming out of the road is Daniels. Pushing up the far side along the baseline. Allen hands it off up top. Enough. And yeah, jumper is good for 16-8. Jan with his first point. 2:15 to go in the first. It's 21-8. There's been a lot of scoring for Trinity here in the first quarter. On the baseline from Monroe. Swing it around. Three ball on the lane. That won't go for Alberry. Running on the run again. Good pass ahead. Wow. That's a pretty left-handed layup for Jan now. 23-8.
He's a good steady player too. Yeah.
He's not fancy. Just really
plays his head.
Timeout to summarize. It's 23-8. So we have Petrini back here with more. And this moment is the CSA. Side to Dunter on the wing. Tried to work out front. Pull up Dunter in the lane. That won't go. And Jimmy will push it back up. Final minute and a half of the first quarter. The first throw is no good, but Nix on the tip dunk underneath on the follow up. Make it 25. Alberry down the lane, split the double team. Nope, but I'll have the free throw line. That foul on Jan Nock. That's his first team fourth.
I like the Sunrise team on this last year.
Yeah, some good players out there. We saw Latino last night.
Yeah.
Strong inside presence. Throwing rattles on Alberry. Nix trying to work down the lane, left the pass underneath. That won't go. Nix again, though. And Otino came down with it. Whistle and a foul. Nix will pick up his second. And team fifth. So Dyson will check out after picking up the second foul here in the first quarter. Tino and he steps out of bounds. Back to Tino.
The big guy probably should be bringing the ball on the court.
You know, if they're trying to get it to him at half court, trying to break the pressure.
Right.
Yeah, you're right. Probably get the ball back to the middle.
Right, very good.
That foul. Albury. That's his second. Team third.
He's got to rack up some fouls here.
Good by Dominique Daniels. Good. Russell traveled in the backcourt. Back over to Trinity, 27-8.
Trinity's hands are so quick.
Goes up to the free throw line, fires a 15-footer, that one go, and a rebound to Otino.
Number two for Otino.
Speaking of bringing on ball before, here he comes.
There he goes. And okay, it's part of it. I'll get rid of it all.
Get to half court, give it up.
He's amazing.
He's awesome. Yeah, but yeah, for his size, not a bad ball handler. And he's a fantastic inside player.
Yeah.
On the lane. Who is up though? They called that on Otano.
I shouldn't have been.
I'm as confused as he is. He looked over like, are you sure?
Yeah, that was not
true. Second team fourth. I think the coach was right back there. He was fouled. It wasn't by him. Three ball in the corner. That wouldn't go. Back the other way on the run. Albury. He'll head to the free throw line. This one a foul on Dominique Daniels. His first. Team six, just 2 seconds to go in the first quarter, and yes, we are still in the first quarter. Trinity's on a pass on this for easily 100 points. Tipped inside, and that tipped up no good, and will end the first quarter. 27-8 is the lead for Trinity at the end of one. Back with quarter number two here in just a moment. You're watching the NCAA. Fires that one down. Clear it out underneath. Nicks. pushing it the other way. On the lane, that's letting go, and rebound cleared underneath by Latino.
Before by Latino. Rebound goal.
Go to the far side from the row. In the post, Palatino with it. Double team there, trying to work back out of that. Swings it around. Runs up the turn.
Shot off. That was good defense on the
field. The free throw line, 34-8. Doesn't matter because that was a nice dunk.
That was worth it.
7-8 down the lane. We got a whistle and a travel after what was a pretty nice move from Peyton Auburn.
I think on his side, that's one. I thought that was pretty good.
If you're going to let the last one go, that one let that go too.
That was a beautiful move. 260 we did from the last two.
Talk about getting up for a dunk.
Yeah.
Jackson can get up for a dunk. Knicks down the lane. Skips it over. Three down in the corner. That won't go. Rebound tipped out. And it will be Sunrise basketball. 4:18 to go in the half. 37-8 is the lead for Trinity. Edwards. to Patino. Double team back outside of Gunter. Down the lane, and that layup is good. Nice kick.
Wow.
Anatoly. 27-10, back to the layup. Whistle. And foul on Marco Malone. That's his first. Team six.
Marco, I can't believe it.
Believe it, Marco.
Yeah. That was bad. Tell you what, there are a lot of people in here watching this game. I mean, you can't really tell from watching it online. You can't see the crowd. First one misses here.
And when you think about how many teams are coming and going and all that, Thursday to have this many here in this game.
Almost
right
a full set of bleachers off the edge to the right.
And
then up above where you see those blue seats, it's about 3 or 4 people deep. There's a lot of people in here watching this one. Second one misses too. By far the biggest crowd we've had all weekend. So Alberry will bring it up. Try to get a step and the whistle on a jump ball. And it will be Kennedy Osborne. Dunk for Dayton Auburn. Well, Sunrise getting a few points toward the end of the half here. 39-15. 50 seconds to go in the first half. Start of half number two. Sunrise will start with it down 41-17. Got a push it far side. Venter with it. Macron with the side for all day. Very down to free throw line. Fires a jumper. That's off the mark. He's kind of lying out of room and then forced up a shot. Line, that's good. So now I'm looking at the record. 3-17. Over the near side for Alberry. Patino along the baseline. And that rattles around the end. Take the ball. From Jackson Pillar. I'm talking about the ability to see the floor and pass the basketball. Still loose, and Otino has the rebound. The front court. Kicking off the bunker. Lost it. Post Ortino, that was a nice entry feed and a good finish from Paul Nino.
It was a beautiful pass inside of Paul. He's a very effective shield against the defensive player.
45-21. Looks like 2-3 zone at the time. Down the lane. Wow, what a take by Alberry. Nothing there, so back up over the cone. Just go in the corner now. Three ball, good.
This is crazy. It's so smooth, so easy.
Let's go with his first bucket. 49. 21. 4:30 to go. So we'll be doing the basketball. Sunrise too, but honestly, it probably should have been a foul more on the Knicks than it should have been. But I think it ended up going off of Sunrise last. Back out front. Throw down the lane, got cut off there, and then traveled here. Marcelino Edwards will check in. Place Moreau. Corner, back down the wing. Knock, all good. Head fake. That'll tail in the air, and then Jan just finished easily off the glass.
play half of that with his head. Very smart.
51-21. Very into the front court. And on the lane. Oh, going there from Latino rattled in and out. Fourth rebound. The corner. Three ball there is good from Dominic Daniels. His third three in the day. And a timeout to Sunrise. 54-21 is the lead for Trinity. 2:38 left to go on the third. We're back here tonight. We're watching the NCAA tournament. Taken out in the hands of Nix. Gunter alley-oop underneath, and wow, somehow Albury caught that in the air, readjusted his body, and laid it in. That was not as easy as it looked. Now, 30-second timeout to Trinity. Coach Lockridge immediately saw something that he didn't like. And that's one of the things we were talking about during that last break. It's about, for him, coaching Trinity, it's not about the score or anything that's going on. It's about just teaching what he wants them to learn, which is one thing I really like. Doesn't matter what the score is, what the situation is, he wants it done right, and that's a good way to be. So 1:59 to go in the third, 54-23. Middle. baseline. That jumper's off the mark. Rebound back up and in underneath. It's going to take back up by the net now. 6:25. Dino on the post. Set up on the count. Again, Alberry. Same for three. Good. I said before, if you leave Bryan open, that can be a problem. So, timeout here, 56-28, 26 seconds to go in the third. To the final 10 seconds of this third quarter. Knicks back out front. Daniels had that block, and that'll do it for the end of the third. 56-28 is the lead for Trinity. Be back with quarter number four here in just a minute. You're watching the NCSAA. Start of the fourth quarter, Otino knocks that away, and now back up with it comes Sunrise. And the Posts get a whistle and a holding foul. Beyond Javier Gilgeous-Glasgow. His third foul and team first. Alberry up front, fires a three. That's no good. And the rebound taken away underneath. Knicks along the baseline had that knocked out of his hands by Otino. Tino back the other way, down the lane, has that blocked by Knicks, and it almost went in. So when it comes, Sunrise to push it up. On the 6:45 to go, and jumping from the free throw line wouldn't go for Albury. Daniels back the other way. Off to Nix. Back to Daniels, kicks it off along the baseline. Good pass on the inside, and Nyack will lay it in. ...58-28. 30-point lead here for Trinity. That pass out front, picked off down the lane, and that's blocked by Albury getting back on defense. Boy, that's a hustle to get back.
He did. He turned on the afterburners that time. I didn't think he had a chance to catch him.
That won't go. Otino tried to get the board, tipped it back out. Chang for three, and that rattles in and out. Rebound underneath. Otino had to take it out of his hands.
That's why he
don't put the ball on the floor once you get that board. And we've got a timeout to Trinity. 5:42 left. Back with more in just a moment. So out of the timeout, Trinity with it here. Swinging around to the far side. Nix in the middle, gives it back out front. Daniels gave it off to Nix to try to kick it baseline. That goes off the foot of the defender. So we'll stay with Trinity.
Does it amaze you how Nix always sees all the court all the time?
And for a lot of people, you know, one of the things you try to teach in high school basketball a lot is don't make the cross-court pass against defense because of picking off.
He can.
He can make the cross-court pass.
Yes. I've seen him
much strength on it that it's like making a pass right next to you. There are a few exceptions to that rule. He is one of them.
Yeah, and you better be awake if you're out on the court with him. You get hit in the head with the ball.
Nix good on the foul. Wow, Dyson got to the hoop and powered through that defense. So that foul on Marco Moreau. That's his third, team second. And a chance at a three-point play here for Nix. That's good.
Okay.
61-28.
I don't think they ever play anything except man-to-man defense. That's it.
Albury trying to swing it around for Gunter. Three ball is off the mark. Rebound taken away underneath. And jump with it comes Trinity. Nix down the lane. Lays it up and in with the right hand. Talk about under control.
All right.
A whistle and a foul out front. Let's see who that was on. It must have been on
right there.
Jackson Pillich. His first team second. Hunter. Baseline to Otino. Got a step. Fires that up. No. And we got a whistle and a pushing foul underneath on Romario Williams Showers. That's his first team third. Tino swings it around to Chang. That's knocked away all the way into the backcourt, and almost tracking it down was Dominique Daniels.
Just about caught it.
That's some speed right there.
Yeah.
I thought he was going to catch it. Mulberry in front.
He gave it a good effort. I'll say that for him.
That runner put up no by Otino.
And Mr. Glasgow, his fifth rebound.
And timeout to Trini. Back with more in a moment. You're watching the NCSAA. So Nick's out on the wing. Back out front, down to 3 minutes to go. 63-28. Trinity taking their time here. I got the feeling that they could probably just run out the rest of this clock.
Well, probably.
If they really wanted to.
I don't think there's much question about that, really.
Knicks on the baseline. Good pass in the middle.
Beautiful pass.
And the layup.
Penetration down the right side, and while he's doing it, passes a beautiful pass over to his teammate.
Jan Jak with the bucket.
And he never throws a pass down to leg, down to feet or up above their head. It's always right up here in their chest there where they can take it and do something with it.
Hunter on the wing for Alberry. Hunter out front. Chang fires the free throw line. That's no good. Rebound underneath. We got a whistle and a foul. That will be on Jan Jak. His second, team fourth. And that pass picked off. Knicks out front, 1:50 left.
Oh, coach must have gone to the bathroom break. Oh, there he is out there. He's out.
Oh. Yeah, he's come out here to try to direct, I think, some of this four corner that he wants to work on a little bit here with Trinity. Make sure, work on rotations and things for future games. Nix down the lane, missed that, rebound put back up and in.
You get the idea he could do that anytime he wants to, too.
Yeah, pretty much. Down to 110 to go, 67-28.
Uh-oh.
That's picked off. Here comes Pillage down the lane and slams it with the right hand.
I saw that coming. Don't do that.
69-28, under a minute to go now. Three ball out front, that won't go. And under 40 seconds to go now, as Nix walks it up into the front court. Cross to Daniels, and that's effectively going to do it. 30 seconds left. The final is going to be 69-28, the win for Trinity, and they will win the Division I championship here for the NCSAA. Final scoring totals. First off, for Sunrise, 2 points for Anatoly Gunter. 1 3-pointer for Brian Chang. 10 points for Paul Otano. 13 for Dayton Albury. Dayton was 3 of 6 in the free throw line. Sunrise, 1 of 8 from 3-point range. For Trinity International, Javier Gilgeous-Glasgow with 1 3-point field goal. 8 for Quentin Lowry, including 2 threes. Madit Mao with 2 points. 11 points for Dominique Daniels, including 3 threes. 12 for Jan Yuck. Jackson Pillich with 12 points. He was 0 for 2 from the line. 21 points for Daishin Nix, including 1 3. He was 8 of 9 from the free throw line. Trinity 7 of 14 from 3-point range. And I'll let you handle the rebounds.
Rebounding, first of all, for Sunrise, we had Dayton Albury with 4, Joe Zhang with 1, Marcelino Edwards had 2, Anatoly Gunter had 2, Marco Moreau had 1, and Paul Otino had 11 for a total of 21. 21 for Sunrise, for Trinity. Dejan Nix had 10. Glasgow had 5. Madit Mao had 1. Dominique Daniels had 2. Jan Nayak had 4. And Jason Pillick had 4 for a total of 26. So Trinity had a 26-21 rebounding edge. 26-21.
And Trinity wins it here in Division One. Up next, we will have just a video-only feed. Our next full broadcast will be coming up at 3 o'clock this afternoon. We will see you back here then. You've been watching the NCSAA.